What up?
Lee Goff, marketingagencycoach.com. On the phone yesterday with a prospect there in Mobile, Alabama. And at one point, there had 90 employees, and I think they're going to bring me on for a couple like power days and some one-on-one coaching. When you get to that level, you know, the blueprint's got some cool tools in it. It's going to help you out like that. But that's, you know, you'll need some just high-end expert advice on that one. So we were talking to them, and they were, and the owner, there's a lot of pain that comes with growth. I want to make sure you know this. So the name of this vlog is To Scale or Not to Scale? That is the question, right? People always want to, always people like, I want to scale, I want to grow, I want to be rich, I want to be Bill Gates, I want to be Steve Jobs, I want to dominate the world, one digital website at a time, right? You know, so scaling is hard, and your profit margins do not go up, they go down. Now, your numbers get bigger, so you make more money. There's no doubt about that. That's a good thing. But you need to take a long, hard look in the mirror and ask yourself, do you want to put up with the headache, man? Whenever you get to that number 50, shit gets real. When you break that seven-figure mark, the IRS is 3 feet up your... It's no bueno, okay? You get into what's called 940, 941s. It starts to get a little bit crazy. And then, of course, again, you get that 50 mark in the Department of Labor, health insurance, all these different things, all these different expenses start to pop up, and you start to eat into your profit margin. So you need to think about it. Do you really want to scale, or do you want to just squeeze as much profit out of this thing? You can become a boutique. You can become a hyper-niched out. Like, I do websites, or I do traffic generation, I do social media management for only underwater basket weaving companies that are from the state of California. But still, you get my point, okay? And so hyper niche out, and then you go after them, and you don't have to be big. You can charge big old premium prices. You can have an agency with 5 to 7 or 7 to 10 people and making $300,000 a year. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. To scale or not to scale? Do you really want to put up the headaches, or is it more about quality of life? You see, that happened to me. I had to prove it to myself. I came from Mississippi, barely graduated one of the worst high schools in the state of Mississippi, finally got into a university, dropped out of college because I was too busy drinking beer and chasing ladies. So I had to prove it to myself that I could do it. Then all of a sudden, I'm like, damn, I did it. It sucked. It's the headaches that come with it are like, man, it's not worth it. And me, I love one-on-one, being in the trenches, problem solving, figuring shit out. That's what I love to do. I wasn't doing it anymore. All I was doing was working with my leadership team and attorneys and CPAs, and, you know, that's all I was doing. I didn't like it at all. So take a long, hard look in the mirror, find out, is it more about quality of life and profit, or is it more about actually building a big, scalable agency? Because that's going to make a huge difference on how you build your agency. Obviously, if you want a sounding board, because I know how lonely it is whenever you're an agency owner. Good God, man, it's like nobody can relate to you. Everybody's, you know, all your buddies building tangible products or houses or whatever the hell it is, and they cannot relate to the pain of scope creep. You know, it's just add another button, right? Whatever, man. Whatever. So if you need a sounding board, you want some free advice, or you want to just kind of talk, you know, hit us up, man. 844-409-0994. info@leegolf.com. We love working with you guys. I want y'all to know that. Again, do some soul searching. Talk to your partner, wife, husband, whoever it is, business partner. Get some advice and make some, do some soul searching on what is really important. Is it more about being able to work 40, 50 hours a week and spending a lot of time with your children, making a good, honest living, $100,000, $200,000, $300,000? Or is it more about changing an industry and going big and working with Coca-Cola and Dell and the country of Fiji like I did? You know, what's your priorities? What do you want to do? Prioritize, figure it out, then go out there and make it rain, baby. Make it rain.